Hi, good morning everyone. Thanks for tuning in today and thanks for joining me in today's session on whom to trust. So we've been discussing an investment and different videos and different topics. I hope you're liking the content and do leave your comments and thoughts, if anything that you feel that can be contributed to this community and for others to benefits. Let's get into today's session on whom to trust. Now, there are things that it's okay, that we got information on where we stand, what we need to do, and what is the way forward. All is fine, but then if you don't know what to do, whom to trust? Now, I just wanted to give you a simple example on a business. Now, any businesses around your block, any businesses what you think that is happening around you, smallest to the biggest. So say for example, someone who is running in a restaurant or someone who is selling grocery stores next to your block. Try to talk to them and try to understand how did they start and what are the challenges they went through. And where are they today? And are they seeing any profits or losses? Things like that. The basic things. You don't need to get deep into it, how things went. But try to understand how each, a smaller to the bigger scale of businesses works. And then you can get a good glimpses of how it works. It's pretty much simple. You are providing a service for others' man's money. Period. So be it in your time form or be it in a product form or be it in terms of which of the services you're providing a value to the other person, the other person is buying your services in return, they are paying you. So it's a simple thing that to understand. Now, why it has to do with whom to trust? Now, unless until you are sure that that person you are taking advice or the person close to your family who is already succeeded and who has a little bit of stability in whatever they're doing in terms of personal life, professional life, that is a person you probably need to look up to and take a bit of advice. I'm not saying that take an advice and just blindly follow through, but then you need to do your own homework before you invest on anything. So, be it in your education, be it in your understanding how a particular business works. Suppose if you want to get into a mutual fund or if you want to get into the NSE, BSEs, you need to educate yourself on how the basic things work and what are the rules. It's not like it's open market that it cannot be that okay you purchased you want to purchase something, just go to open market and buy it and go. So what are the rules and regulations set by the SEBI, or you could say the what is it driven, what driven rules and how that will affect you. Those basic things that you need to educate yourself, understand yourself. Now, the good news is to all of us is that our education will not teach you on your finances, period. You need to figure it out on your own and how it works. And the better you learn faster it is, the better you have an understanding to understand how it works and then try yourself, fail yourself, and then that gives you a bit of edge on what calls to take and what not to take moving forward for you when you had to take a big bets in terms of your finances. Now, as I said, good news is that information around us is all around us. Information what we have today is all around us. Now, it's a very simple thing that you need to understand. You need to ask the right questions, answers are right in front of you. Maybe you don't, and then which always just based on someone else's answers, you don't decide. And then you use your common sense, you use your logic, and how does it fit into it? And does that answers what you're reviewing or seeing in your whatever the forms, the Google it or Yahoo, XYZ, is it making sense to you and looking at the society around? And these things will only develop when you develop your knowledge on how it works. And something you don't know or something you're not sure before you're investing, don't do it because it is basically based on certain facts and figures that we invest, and that's not the right way to do, but then understand how it works. I'll get a little deep into it on where to invest, because I'm going to link whom to trust and where to link in 2 3 videos, like what mistakes I have done on each and area of where I had invested. And I'm sure I did get a good returns on certain things that which I had invested, but then again it came through the experience. And whom to trust? Don't trust anybody who is telling you, trust me, take this call, trust me, buy this mutual fund, trust me, buy this insurance. Nothing. Don't trust anyone, because end of the day they're trying to sell the product, and for their a little bit of brokerage what they're going to get. And whether do it or whether what happens to your investments, they honestly don't care, unless until you, as I said, truly trust the product. Okay, you take advice. Okay, someone is telling, okay, this is a product, but then you do your analysis and you do certain, suppose someone tell you, okay, this is a mutual fund which is doing good. So all you need to do is, okay, that's fine. Don't rush in taking decisions, because it's you have enough time to understand if that product, particular product, is good or bad. And you do analysis, you go Google it, and you see, and then you see the past performance and who is the fund manager and what are the the places where they had invested in, and what are the returns in that particular areas are giving. So then you take your calls. Maybe you don't need to, if you're really confident enough that product is doing good, that particular mutual fund is doing good, you can take a small bets and see yourself giving a time frame of 6 to 1 month, 6 months to 1 year, and see if that was given any 6%. The people can tell you, this fund is outperforming, and that will give you 25% of returns, 15% of returns, 8% of returns. But you see yourself, start investing 1,000 rupees in it, just to see yourself, 1 year goes by, and then just see how much of returns it gave you. And that gives you a little bit of confidence rather than someone telling you blindly. And then I made so many mistakes like that, on which I'll come back to you. And then it's, so don't trust when someone said trust me, because end of the day it's your money, your hard-earned money, and then it is very difficult for you to save first phase. And then when you save that 10% or 20%, you need to find the right channels to diversify so that you can see the return. So that is the most important thing that you need to take out of this video. So if someone asks you whom you had to trust, no one but you. Okay, so how you can trust yourself? Taking Educating yourself with the sources of resources available. Now, if you, why did I mention about the early start of my video about understanding how the businesses work? So that gives you a little bit of edge on how actually it works, and reading books on those ones, watching the videos on those ones, and how does actually the compounding works, and how does the long term staying long enough? How someone say that okay, waiting 20 years is too long. Waiting 10 years is too long. Waiting 30 years is too long. Waiting 40 years is too long. So, for which I had already mentioned, what if you survive 40 years and then you don't have anything for you to survive? And so it depends on, again, what kind of risk you're ready to take and what kind of bets you want to take. But then slowly, step by step, you will build that confidence over a period of time. Now, what is the most important thing is trying to understand the concept of investing and concept of compounding. Now, okay, say I want to, I mean, I cannot wait 20 years, I cannot wait 30 years, I want to receive cash flow time to time, very often, and I cannot wait. And there is an option. You have a good money to invest in a real estate. You buy an apartment for your rental purposes. Where do you have 30, 40 lakhs in a worst case scenarios that today to put that cash and start generating an income? Now, imagine if you're if you have a liquid cash of 30 lakhs, you can do that today, well and good. That's a one investment that you could do. Over a period of time, the property appreciates. For a period of time, the rental revenue will start coming right after you rent out property. But it has a different approach altogether. But then it's never a time that you're going to have a liquid cash of anywhere between 30 lakhs to 50 lakhs to 1 crore in your hand, so that you could invest in a real estate property where you get a returns of 20 or 30,000 a month. Well, in a long run, probably it can appreciate the property. But do you really have 30, 40, 50 lakhs to 1 crore that today a liquid cash without having anything that you can invest in real estate to get the revenue generating month on month? That's most likely not the case. So all these small steps where you can invest going slowly, you can do it. So I'll come back to on those one how it can build up a corpus where you could invest on a real estate for your own house, first of all, to live, how long you want to live in a rental properties. And at the end of the day, at some point of time, you need to have your own address for you and for your family to live. Those things takes time unless until you're very comfortable buying with the liquid cash of 30, 40 lakhs. In a worst case scenario, 30 lakhs is the bare minimum that you need to invest in a two-bedroom flat in a different cities of based on whichever the way you're living in. But that's not the case, in most case scenarios when you think of investing 10% and 10%, 10%, and then yes, you need to even go for a loan. You need to have about minimum 10% to 12% of down payment for you to invest in any of the real estate. So we'll come back to that. So understanding, educating yourself, and most importantly, it's your hard-earned money. You know where you're investing. Don't let it just because of some false advices you receive. Just don't put it somewhere. Think hoping it will work out. It's like basically you're gambling. So it just four numbers or five numbers out of 100 numbers you need to get it. But then, what is the success rate on those ones is something that you need to ask yourself before you're doing those kind of bets. So, with the note of luck, actually, so I'll be coming with a different video on whom to trust and where to invest and where I did investments on different aspects and what are the advisors so-called gave me and what have I observed from those ones and the lessons I learned. And then, yes, I just said, there are some good bets I took over a period of time which gave me the results as well. But then there are many failures on that process too. So, with that, I'd like to leave you today. Bigger, do good, influence the people, and stay tuned, stay blessed. If you like this video, keep sharing with the people, friends, and families who needs to be educated on a financial education. And I hope that helps someone, some part of the world. To see yourself growing in terms of finances for your future and family's future. Stay tuned, stay blessed, bigger, do good, and influence the people around you. Thank you.